Hi, this is Alex from phpacademy.org and this is a video tutorial for the new Boston. Now in this video I'm going to be briefly explaining and demonstrating the PREG match function. Now the PREG match function looks like this, and what it is it takes expression matching and lets us do this. So what is expression matching? Well, it's basically matching patterns inside of a string. So we could say, we could use this function to check if a string exists inside of a string, but we can also take on more complex patterns and check for these inside of strings. So I'm not going to be demonstrating some of the more complex patterns because with the amount of different expressions that you can use to check for patterns, we would literally be here for hours because there's lots and lots of different ways you can check. But what we're going to be doing is we're going to be creating an example of just checking for a string inside of a string. So let's go ahead and create our string data. And this is going to be equal to this is a string. Now what we want to do is we want to check to see if we find a match inside of this string. Now what the PREG match function will not do is tell you where the match is. It will just show you, it will just return a 1 or a 0 depending on if there's a match. So what we can do is we can put this into an if statement and the condition will either return 1 or 0, which is going to be the function itself. Therefore, if it equals 1, then we have found a match. If it equals 0, then we haven't found a match. So let's go ahead and create our if statement, and let's also create our else as well. So we've created an if else statement. Now what we want to do is inside the condition area, we want to give the function, so preg match and then brackets. So in here we're going to take two parameters. The function itself takes three parameters, I think, but we're just going to be giving it two. So essentially what we're going to be doing is searching for a string inside of this string up here that we've predefined. So let's say we chose the word is. We want to see if there's an is in here. We could also do it with simply something like, is there any spaces in this string? So we'll go for both examples and we'll demonstrate this twice. So the first parameter is the expression, the pattern that you want to match for, and the second parameter is the string itself, so the string data. And this can either be supplied in using a variable, or you can add your plain text in here. Okay, so we're going to be feeding in string, that's there, and we're going to be searching for a particular word. So the simplest way that you could possibly do this is two forward slashes, and then in the middle of these two forward slashes is the word that you're searching for. So this is just basically meaning as this is. So we're searching for is inside this string. That's essentially what we're doing with these two forward slashes here, containing this is. So if our if this returns 1, that's going to mean that it is found, which at the moment we know that it is going to be. So in here we can echo out match found. And in else what we can do is echo out no match found if we can't find a match. So let's go ahead and open up our browser and test this. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to refresh the page and see what we get up. So it now says match found. We knew that it would do that because we know that the word is contained within a string, or within this string. So now let's just simply put a space to see if it will return match found. Okay, so it's saying match found. So what we could do is we could have a function that would check, for example, for a space in a program, or sorry, in a string. And we'll do that a bit later when I've explained a bit more about this function. Now what happens if we don't know what this string is? We might want to search for a specific pattern inside of a string, and when we don't know how the string is formed or what we're feeding in, so we're just double checking something.